guys, welcome back to Math in a Hoodie. I hope you guys are having a great day. Today we're going to talk about adding numbers, okay? We're going to add single digit numbers together to come up with new answers. But before we do that, can you guys count with me? Let's count to 20 first, because those are the numbers that we're going to be using when we count with single digits. Okay, let's count to 20. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Good job. Okay, so now that I know you can count to 20, that tells me that you can do adding these math problems. Because if you can count to 20, you can do addition. It's that easy, guys. So let's get started. Okay, let's get started, guys. We're adding single digits. And when we add something, that means we put it together, right? Let's say you're packing to go on your trip and your mom says, will you add your swimming suit to the suitcase? That means, will you bring your swimming suit to the suitcase, right? Adding means bringing. Mom, can you add a dessert to my lunch for school today? Adding means putting something extra in it. We're bringing together something when we add, okay? So I have three numbers on here. I'm sorry, four. That's actually number four. Let's fix that. Okay, so I have four math problems on here where we're adding two digits together. Okay, see this one, we're adding 1 plus 9. This one, we're gonna add 5 plus 5. This one, we're gonna add 2 plus 2. And this one, we're gonna add 0 plus 8. Do you think we can do it? I think we can. Let me tell you about a trick that I use when I do addition and I add two numbers together. I try and find something that I can use to represent the numbers. Now in math terms, they call this a manipulative. And what that means is they just want you to have a visual of each of these numbers so you can see them put together. Does that make sense? So you could use anything. You could use your fingers. You could use marbles. You could use erasers or crayons. Some people use paper clips because their mom and dads have lots of paper clips at home. You could use crackers or pretzels. You can use whatever you want to help visualize and see each of these numbers, okay? But today, we're going to just use some visualizations or some manipulatives that I have here with me, okay? So let's start with number one. Now, if you didn't have anything at home or you're doing a test and you can't use anything but your pencil and paper, you can draw manipulatives. You can draw a visual on your paper. Let's do that. Okay, so the first number is number one. Let's draw a little circle for number one. Okay, next number is 9. Let's draw 9 little circles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 1 plus 9. Now to find the answer, we just have to add them all up. Let's count all the circles and that'll tell us the total. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. When we count all of them, we have 10. So 1 plus 9 is 10. See how we did that? When you use a visual, you can see it, okay? Now, what if we would have done that on our fingers, okay? We have 1, and now we're going to add 9. Let's use 9 fingers and count it out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10. 10, and the answer is 10. See how you could use your fingers, or you could draw little dots? Either one of those works. Okay, let's do number two. Okay, let's try number two. Number two says 5 plus 5. For this one, I'm just going to draw lines, okay? So how many do we have first? We have five. Let's draw five lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? And then we have five again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now to add those together, we're just going to count all of our lines, and that'll tell us what 5 plus 5 is. Should we do it? Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Hey, that answer is 10 too. So 5 plus 5 is 10. Okay, let's circle that in red so we can see the answer. See how we did that? Again, we could use our fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And add 5 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many do we have? 10. All right, let's use a different manipulative, should we? Okay, I'm going to use these dolls. I have these little mermaid dolls, okay? And it says 2 plus 2. So I have 2 dolls plus 2 dolls. Now to find out what 2 plus 2 is, we're going to add them all together, aren't we? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2 plus 2 is 4. Let's go ahead and write down that answer. See, we could have used anything around the room to visualize it. And again, we could have used our fingers 2 and 2 and counted them, which would have been 4. Okay, last one, guys. 0 plus 8. For this one, I'm going to use some markers. Okay, let's count out 8 markers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We have 8 markers. And how much are we going to add to it? We're adding 0. We're not adding anything to it. So what's 0 plus 8? If I added a big 0 to it, what is my answer going to be? It's going to be the 8, isn't it? Any number plus 0 is always going to be that number, because 0 means nothing. Zilch, nada. So nothing plus 8 is still going to be 8. So there's our answer. Nothing plus 5 would still be 5. Nothing plus 10, we forgot to do this in red, would still be 10. Okay, so when you add 0 to any number, the answer is going to be that number, because 0 means zilch. Okay, all right. Let's go ahead and do a word problem that has to do with adding single digits, okay? You guys are doing great. Okay, guys, let's do one last exercise with adding single digits, okay? And when we do word problems, we have to put our thinking caps on so we can listen to the key parts of the problem, okay? Here we go. Listen carefully. Jason has 7 puzzles. Quincy has the same number of puzzles. How many puzzles do they have together? Remember, together, we're putting all of the puzzles together. We're putting both Jason's and Quincy's together, and it wants to know how many they have total. All right, so let's write down the key things from this word problem that we're going to want to remember. So there were 2 people, weren't there? There was Jason, and there was Quincy. Okay, now it said Jason had 7 puzzles. Let's write the 7 right there. Now it says Quincy has the same number of puzzles. What does that mean, same number? Quincy has the same as Jason? She does. And how many did Jason have? 7. Good job. So Quincy also has 7. Now it wants us to add 7 and 7 so we know how many parts or puzzles we have total. Okay, so let's go ahead and do, how about we do some green lines, shall we, to help us figure this one out. Okay, so let's do 7 lines for Jason. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And let's do 7 lines for Quincy. 1, 2, 3, 4, five, six, seven. Now, what do we need to do to find out our answer? Do you remember? We need to count all of the lines together. Let's do it. So we know this is seven, right? So let's start from here. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. So when we add all the puzzles together, we have 14 total. So our answer is 14 puzzles. Okay? I hope that this has helped to make a little more sense to you guys and that you're learning how to add single digits. You're doing such a great job. It really is kind of easy to learn when you can write out the manipulatives or visuals or use anything around your house that you have as a visual so that you can see the numbers and add them together. Okay? All right, you guys, thanks for watching the video. I'll see you next time.